So here's the code. It's just 20 lines or so, and I've left out a couple pieces to give you something to do. But let me first try to explain how it works. So we take a pattern and a text. We're breaking down the pattern into its components, and the components are an operator and then an X and a Y part, depending on the definition. And so, for example, the literal will only have an X component, sequence and alternative will have both an X and a Y. And we'll see how that component is written later, but for now, just assume it's going to pick out the right pieces. And then we decide which operator we have, literal, sequence, alt, and so on, and return a proper set accordingly. So for example, if the operator is asking for a literal, string X, we ask, does the text start with X? If it does, then the remainder will be a singleton set, a set of just one element, which is the remainder of the text after we've broken off the length of text characters. So if we matched a three-character sequence for X, we return the text without the first three characters. If X was one character, we return the text without the first character. Otherwise, we return the null set. There's no match. The alternative is particularly nice. It says if we have an alternative between X and Y, we just return the union of those two match sets. This character, the or bar, means union in Python, union of two sets. Sequence is a complicated one. It says if we're asked for a sequence of X and Y, we first find the matching set for X. That's going to be a set of possible remainders. And we go through all of those and then take the remainder of that text, which would be T1, and then match Y against that remainder. And for each of those alternatives, that's what we're going to return in the set. So, for example, if this is our pattern, sequence of star literal A plus literal B, looks like that, and we're matching against AAAB, then the match, then X is the star literal A, and Y is the plus literal B, and the match set for X is this set here. We try to match Y, the plus literal B, against all of these match sets, and it'll fail to match against each of these three. It will match against this one, and so now we have a match that consumes the entire string, and the result from the match of the sequence of X and Y will be the set consisting of just the empty string because we've matched off all the A's and 1B, and there's no remainder left over. Note that there's a big difference between the outcome of saying, here's a result consisting of one string, the empty string, versus a set that's the empty set. So the empty set is a failed match, and the set consisting of the empty string, that's a successful match. Now let's see if you can fill in your code for these two missing cases here. Remember, you're going to be returning a set of possible remainders if the match is successful.